It's supposed to be a done deal, but could the Cincinnati streetcar yet get derailed? Now, the mayor vows it's going to revitalize a key local corridor. But News 5's John London is live to show why critics won't get on board. John?
Well, Jack, in part because police and fire expect hundreds of layoffs possibly next month. City Manager Milton Dehoney stressing to us earlier this month that streetcar funds are restricted capital dollars that can be used only for a project that will turn the corner around here in about 3 years.
Whether you are on board or not, the streetcar is fast becoming a symbol of the city's budget situation.
We're all being swindled to believe that the streetcar is necessary and needed right now in the city of Cincinnati.
A new campaign to kill it is underway. One theme pits personal safety against streetcar.
We're urging everybody to come to the first budget hearing on December 1st at Duke Energy Convention Center at 6 p.m. and let council know what you want.
Police and fire unions, community activists, tax opponents, all aligning to try to make it an either-or issue, layoffs, or as they derisively describe it, a trolley. But with city leaders saying 90% of the funding is present and accounted for, there appears to be no brake to pull. The vice mayor says phase one will be built, period.
And, you know, when you're also worried about whether or not you have your job, that can sometimes lead to people becoming very emotional and perhaps not as fact-based as would be preferred.
Citizens seem to like the model that was brought in from Oregon this month, but no ground has been broken, no funding's in place to take the tracks beyond the Vine Street Hill into Uptown, and no way of paying for operating it has been put in place. Former Congressman and one-time Mayor Tom Lucan has formed CAS, Citizens Against Streetcar Swindle, and they smell opportunity.
Did they not pay attention to what happened on the first Tuesday in November? We've got new leadership.
Now, some see beef to that statement, others mere bravado, but get ready for streetcar as a recurring theme as lawmakers deal with that $60 million deficit in December. Reporting live, John London, News 5.
You talked about capital funds. The feds are helping to build the streetcar, but any estimate of how much it'll cost taxpayers to operate it, John?
They don't know that yet, Jack. They're looking at three things. They're looking at fares, as you've heard about. They're also looking at a tax on properties along the route, a special assessment fee, they would call it, and also advertising, sponsorship. But as Vice Mayor Qualls put it tonight, if there's some subsidy involved, it's not going to be, she says, $3 million.
John London, thanks.